this particular wetland project here at the NVF site is really a combination of many different things. It's first and foremost a remediation effort. We've removed a lot of zinc from soils through the creation of this wetland, but it also offers flood storage to the Red Clay Creek, which is right back behind me. During high flow events, we can capture some of that water, give it a place to go, and let it perk back into the ground as opposed to flooding out, you know, some of the areas that are typically prone to flooding around here. Right now it's a little brown. We do have landscapers getting ready to plant some trees and shrubs behind me. We're also gearing up to put some seed down. We do have a little bit of work in the actual wetland. The pond behind me shouldn't really be a pond, but right now it is. We've got to do some dewatering, get some fill in there. Another 2 feet approximately of fill will go into the bottom of this pond, but we need to remove the water in order to do that. The short version of how we got to this point is, number one, a lot of environmental assessment, soil, groundwater, samples, analysis, to get a good handle on the distribution of contaminants at this site. A lot of buildings had to come down, which you've probably seen in some of the other footage. Now, once those buildings were down, we could actually assess what's in the ground beneath those buildings. Again, the short story is we did do all of that. We got a handle on the inventory of contamination we needed to deal with, and we designed a multi-benefit plan to remediate the site and provide some additional function and beauty for future redevelopment purposes. The main contaminant of concern at this site was zinc. Zinc chloride was used extensively in the vulcanized fiber making process that occurred at this site, you know, beginning in the early 1900s. So zinc chloride in the groundwater and in the soil was our main problem. By removing a lot of the soil that had zinc bound within it, we removed all of that mass. Through the soil removal project and some sampling that was done on a daily basis to kind of get a hold of this inventory, we've removed approximately 170 tons, which is almost 340,000 pounds of zinc with the soil that was removed from the site. Approximately 1,600 truckloads of soil were removed from the area behind me. The other problem we have here is dissolved zinc in the groundwater, and we have a treatment system that captures groundwater naturally before it discharges to Red Clay Creek. I can say that this wetland creation, zinc source removal project, is an approximate $3 million project. The calculations that I've done, now that I have some data to compute with, indicated to me that it would take approximately 40 years to remove the zinc should it get in the groundwater. When I equate that to costs for a monthly treatment system that we currently have, we're going to talk somewhere in the neighborhood of $14 million. So at this point, the state has spent $3 million, and just from the groundwater treatment system components, we can save approximately $14 million in the long run. The whole object of this remedial effort is to keep that zinc from the red clay. This remedial effort really goes a long way to keeping the surface soils out of the creek. The capping that we've done will keep even more of it out of the creek. And then again, our groundwater treatment system behind us collects the water prior to discharge to the creek, treats it so all of that zinc isn't going directly into the red clay. Well, there are certainly other benefits. Number one is aesthetics. The whole area here is slated for potential redevelopment. We've been working for years trying to get this place ready for other developers to come in and potentially put some residential amenities, some commercial amenities, shops, restaurants, cafes. That's all sort of the future plans for this area. None of that can happen until the land is ready to be built upon, and it certainly wasn't safe for that type of redevelopment prior to the efforts that we've put into cleaning up this site. Parks does have plans to connect a lot of these trail systems right here through this particular site. There'll be a trail that skirts the building behind me and comes right around where we're standing and will help to connect some of the stuff that's been built on both sides of the valley. We had to reconstruct this cross stream, is what we call it. This actual stream used to run right through the NVF buildings. Through our resurrection or revamping of this cross stream, we needed to put some stabilizing structures in because we rescaped it. We used these little willow bundles that are staked into the ground on both sides of the stream here. And the idea is that those willow bundles will get wet, they will sprout, and we'll actually get stabilization of the creek banks with willow. Well, what I hope it means to a lot of people is that we can utilize state resources to really get a good benefit and something to give back to the state. Once we have this area redeveloped, the tax base goes up. We have more amenities for folks in this area to use. It's just a beautiful area of Delaware that other people should definitely see, and many probably haven't. So this will actually provide a destination over time for folks to come and enjoy this part of Delaware.